Welcome back to Amazing Websites Television, the show where intelligent people like you can find the tools to change the rules. Welcome to the Cayman Islands. Welcome back to the show. Today I'm standing in the center of Georgetown, Grand Cayman Islands. You can see here, just over here, here we have the port, over here we have the beach, and just back here it is all the touristic locations. But also, remember, this is a fiscal paradise, and of course it's a very, very nice location. On today's show, we're going to be having another very interesting person. His name is Mike Warren, and he's going to be telling you about how to buy judgments so that you can actually make money online buying judgments. And that sounds a bit weird, but it's going to be very, very interesting. We're going to be having James Shramko again, and you're going to be getting quite a lot of great information. So let's get started with the first section of the show, which is going to be Handy Bookmarks. Welcome back to Handy Bookmarks. On this episode, I have five very creative tools that I think that you're going to find very, very interesting. The first creative tool that I want to share with you is called QR Stuff. And this is a way in how you can create QR codes for doing absolutely everything. Sending emails, adding videos, sending people to your Facebook page, whatever you want. Very, very interesting. Now, if you have never used QR codes, I want to tell you that more and more you're going to start using QR codes because it is the way in how you can integrate the offline world with the online world. For example, recently I went to Lakewood Church. Possibly you have heard of Joel Osteen. Well, I think he's a master in marketing, and I think the way that he's using it, as you can see here in his offers envelope, he has a possibility of including a QR code, plus also he has all sorts of possibilities so that you will be able to put your offering for the church, which I think is just absolutely great. So you can see now more and more institutions and more people are already using QR codes. So I hope that you enjoy QRstuff.com. Our second resource I think you're going to find absolutely phenomenal, and it's called Infogr.am. So it actually reads Infogram, but of course it's Infogr and then .am. And basically what you can do here is create your own beautiful infographics. This is like nothing that I have ever seen before. You're going to absolutely love it. You will be able to customize your infographs, and they're absolutely fantastic. Now, the next one is called EWCPresenter.com. And this one is a way in how you can create PowerPoint presentations on HTML5. This is also very creative, very innovative. Now, what is what happens? For example, let's say that you want to include a PowerPoint presentation on your website. What is what happens? Well, normally it will not play by itself, or you will have to record it with a video capture software like Camtasia or something like that. With this, you will be able to actually create an actual presentation into HTML5 so that you can embed it in any website. Very, very useful. The next one is called videonote.es, same as the infogram. It reads video notes, but it's videonote.es, video notes. And this one is very interesting. For example, let's say that you're watching a video, let's say that you're watching a webinar, and you don't have the possibilities of typing, or you have only one screen. Well, this is very interesting. It just just puts your video into half of the screen. The other half of the screen becomes a notebook where you can take notes of whatever is happening on the video. I think it's also very useful. And the very last resource that I want to share with you is called Archify. It's a fantastic tool that you can use to basically whatever you see on the web and on the web, you just click Archify, 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 whatever thing that you find interesting on the web. You will just install this plugin on your browser. It exists for Opera, it exists for Internet Explorer, for every single browser there is, for Chrome, and for Firefox. And basically what you do is you just install that plugin there, and then whenever you see something which is interesting on the internet, just archive, and then you can actually start saving all the cool stuff that you find on the internet. So I hope that you have find these five resources interesting, and now it's time that we go to the next section of the show, which is going to be on the go with Web 3.0. On today's On The Go with Web 3.0, I want to share with you two videos that are actually done by Heineken Beer. Heineken is very, very creative on their marketing, and I think the way that they are using QR codes and also apps, it's very, very powerful. First of all, let's just have a look. A moment ago, we were talking about QR codes, and right now, let me just show you how Heineken is using QR codes to actually spread a message within one confined environment. Very interesting. Have a look. Very interesting, don't you think? Well, now think about ways in how you can actually incorporate QR codes on your marketing. Now, let's go to the next video, and I think on this video, you're going to see how Heineken is using an app to get interactivity in the football games, in the UEFA, actually, in the UEFA Cup, which I think is very, very interesting, because an app like that could be very, very powerful. I mean, I tell you, I have seen the app. It's very, very simple. So now the question is, how can you create something within your business that could also really help you with a very, very easy app like this one from Heineken? Have a look. very nice, don't you think? Well, I hope that you have enjoyed this section of Web 3.0, and now I think it's time that we go to the next section of the show, which is going to be Advanced Business Strategies with James Ramco.
James Ramco here, and this episode is about using images in your marketing. So I'm a big fan of using images in marketing, and that's because places like Facebook really reward it. But it goes beyond that. Of course, you've got sites like Pinterest proving that people are visually oriented. You can now put your watermark on your image to get other people sharing your pictures, which in effect is like having user-contributed banner advertising. Plus, we all possess an iPhone or similar, so you can actually create original images that look amazing with your camera and perhaps an app or two for a dollar or $2. I like the Camera Plus app, and it allows you to turn pictures into something stunning. By putting these pictures, you are engaging people and getting you're getting emotion out there, and you're having discussions. Now, here's an interesting thing. When we put thumbnail pictures on the front of superfastbusiness.com, it halved our bounce rate. That's right, it halved. So when you take advantage of image sharing sites, and I would include Facebook as an image sharing site, you can really get traffic back to your site, you can get awareness and engagement. So here's what I suggest you do. Make your standard operating procedure that every single post you put on your website has a picture. Make the picture original. Either get a cartoon drawn by someone custom, or use a picture that you take with your camera, like I do from my episodes on Think, Act, Get and Freedom Ocean, or hand draw something. But the point is, don't use those cheesy stock pictures of people shaking hands and all that. No one likes those images. They're cheesy and they're drab and they're boring. Plus, Google's already indexed them before. You can go to a site called Tin Eye and just see how many copies of stock pictures there are out there. So use original pictures. Put them on every single post. Share your post to Facebook and Pinterest, and sometimes upload them to Twitter. And make sure that you're doing this on a continual basis, and you'll start to polarize and engage and get better response from your audience. Well, I'm James Ramco. I hope you found this tip useful. Post your comments about how you're using image marketing.
On today's episode, I have Mike Warren, which is the king of judgment, and you're going to find what he's going to tell you very, very interesting. So, Mike, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much. Glad to be here.
Why do they call you the king of judgment? I think that's a weird name.
Well, they call me the king of judgments because I found a way of doing some simple research online where I make money from something called a money judgment. A money judgment is where somebody has sued somebody else and gotten a judgment against them, but they haven't been paid on it. And I found a way to do a little bit of research online, so totally online, from any country in the world, and I can make money. And I can show anybody else how to do the same thing.
Yeah, the reason why I wanted to bring Mike on the show is because, of course, he's actually teaching something which is very innovative in my eyes, which has to do on how to make money online. So can you just possibly give us your best secret
so
on how to
secrets,
do it?
So you have the secrets, huh? Okay.
Of course.
All right, we'll jump right to Chase. I'll give you number one secret. So here's what I do. And y'all really want to pay attention. It's very, very powerful, super, super profitable, and super easy. So what I do is I go online and I look for real estate. Now, I know you may say, oh, wait a minute, I'm not interested in real estate. And I get it. You may not be. And I'm not interested in buying a property either. So here's what I do. Let's follow through this. I go online and I look for property, real estate, either residential, commercial, anywhere in the world that's currently for sale or under contract. Now, what I mean by under contract is that there's a buyer in place who wants to buy that property right now. Not me, not you, not you. Okay, so somebody else is buying it. The next step I do is I go online, so I let my fingers tap dance on a keyboard. Right, this is tap dancing on a keyboard. So I let my fingers tap dance on the keyboard. I find deals where I look to see if the owner of the property has a judgment against them. As soon as I find a judgment, I contact the person who owns that judgment, and I negotiate the right to buy that judgment for cash. So let's go through an example. So let's say we take a $10,000 judgment that I find. I contact the person who owns the judgment. I say, hey, would you like to have $5,000 in cash for your judgment? They all say yes, they'd like to have it. Now, I might have to negotiate a little bit on the number, but they all want to sell. So what I do, though, here's the important part, is in order for real estate to sell, in order to give clear title to a new buyer, you have to pay off the debts on the property, which includes that judgment. So when that judgment pays off at $10,000, I use the payoff proceeds to actually buy the judgment. So when it pays off at 10, the $5,000 goes to the person who owns the judgment to pay them the money I said to repay. That $5,000 spreads. That's my profit, your profit, your profit. You made $5,000 on a deal that you didn't have to come up with any cash in advance to buy it, and you did it all online. I mean, it's very simple, it's proven, and it's very smart, and everybody should be looking at it, because there's millions and millions and millions of these deals anywhere in the country. I mean, I have students in Australia, New Zealand, United Kingdom, Ukraine, India, Canada, Mexico, the United States, finding deals in different countries or in the U.S., wherever you want to find it, and making money simply online.
That is fantastic. Well, as you can see, this is a very innovative way on how to generate income online. So just for their benefit, would you be so kind in telling my audience where they can get in touch with you?
Oh, sure. Happy to. Simply go to my website. So grab a pen and write this down. Go to misuniversity.com. So it stands for Multiple Income Streams University. So misuniversity.com. And I'm Mike Warren. Thanks for having me on the show.
Fantastic. Thanks for coming, Mike. And now it's time that we go to the next section of the show, which is going to be One App a Day Keeps Boredom Away.
If you're like most people, you probably carry a variety of paper and plastic loyalty cards. Keyring is a smartphone app that eliminates clutter by digitizing all of your loyalty, rewards, and membership cards and making them accessible at the touch of your finger. Cards can be added in seconds by simply scanning the barcode or browsing through our pre-populated directory. You can even share cards with your family members. And unlike physical cards, Keyring lets you instantly sign up for new rewards programs from the top retailers with zero paperwork, receive digital coupons, exclusive offers, and more, all direct to your mobile device. Join millions of Keyring users who have said no more cards.
So now it's time for me to go enjoy a nice, great drink over there in Margaritaville here in Georgetown, Great Cayman. And I hope that you have enjoyed the content of today's show. Make sure to watch this same show next week. Next week we're going to be having another great guest. We're going to be having lots of amazing content. So make sure to watch Amazing Websites Television next week. This is Ernesto Verdugo saying goodbye from Georgetown, Cayman Islands. Bye-bye.